David Pogue now takes us dining with the stars.
Eating in space is trickier than it looks.
You have to be careful. Every time you open any container in space, everything tends to want to fly out.
You eat straight out of the envelope?
Yeah, you'll open your envelope up, and then you take your spoon and just eat. Clean off your spoon with a wet wipe at the end of it, and then it's ready for the next meal.
Frank Rubio recently spent 371 consecutive days on the space station, a NASA record.
The thing that I missed the most was just fresh food. You just never have fresh fruit, fresh vegetables, a salad.
So it's not, I think, a little more salt. It's not that.
Right. Food science is very different from being a chef.
At the Johnson Space Food Systems Laboratory in Houston, NASA food scientist Grace Douglas and food manager Shulei Wu have helped to develop a menu of 200 different dishes for space station dining.
What we're doing is looking at engineering and microbiology and chemistry and how we can make those foods stable for long amounts of time. So we have to make sure that they're safe and they taste really good for those lengths of time.
The space station has no traditional oven, stove, fridge, or freezer, only a little pouch warmer.
So this is a mango salad.
Wow, excellent, with a subtle bouquet of recirculated air.
To ensure a 3-year shelf life, every pouch has either been freeze-dried, heat-stabilized, or irradiated.
We're in Texas, so we had to try this barbecue beef brisket, and this is a irradiated product.
Also excellent. I can barely taste the gamma rays.
Even the rehydrated turkey was delicious.
Just like Mom used to make. And so there you go. Curried pumpkin soup, squash, turkey, spicy green beans, mango salad, cherry blueberry cobbler, your classic Norman Rockwell Thanksgiving dinner.
A Mars mission, though, will be a bigger challenge. It might require 5 years worth of food, too heavy to launch with the astronauts.
Does anyone ever talk about, you know, a pill or an energy drink that has all the nutrients you need in it?
Well, this goes back to variety, because if we think about food on Earth, we celebrate around food. It becomes very important. There's concepts out there of, well, we can produce a lot of algae or something else. If you worked really hard all day and you're really tired and you come home, and what would you want to eat with your friends?
You're saying probably not an algae pill.
Probably not.
As for astronaut Frank Rubio, it was time to ask the big question.
Globules of water floating in microgravity and going after. Is that just a stunt for the camera that gets old after a day?
Yeah, almost every meal, you'll have somebody be like, hey, you know, Woody, or hey, Steve, catch, right? Playing with your food is one of the small privileges that we have while we're up there.